So I'm joined here today by Nick Hudson, who's an artist who's just been to the Arctic.
Yeah, went up to Svalbard.
Yeah.
The northernmost settlement in the world.
Yeah. So what was the reason for your trip? Because I know there's an artist angle to it.
Yeah, I'm working on a project called The Quiet Earth with my collaborating friend H.A. Budak, which explores landscape, psychogeography, sort of the way humans interact with landscape and how the effects of that can bounce back from the landscape into the human body and all of this stuff. So looking into irradiated landscapes as well as those that have been sort of corroded by excessive human intervention, but also looking at ways that we can collaborate with landscape as the guests within it that we are.
Yeah.
And thinking of sort of new ways to perceive our interaction with landscape that don't involve destroying it, essentially.
Is there a climate change aspect to this?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Hence, I was going up to the Arctic, of course. Which was fascinating.
Yeah. So you were shooting film, you were taking photographs.
Yeah,
what's your exhibition? Because I know you're doing an exhibition there.
Yeah, the project involves gathering audiovisual field data, as in, say, footage and field recordings from wilderness sites all across the world. But also we've been to CERN, I've been to an abbey used in one of Tarkovsky's films over in Tuscany, just gathering loads and loads of footage. I went to Litvinenko's grave, the grave of the Russian spy who was killed with radioactive polonium.
Yeah.
I gathered field recordings there, and the idea being that with this we're going to generate 12 15-minute short films, which we're going to exhibit all over the place. The first has been exhibited in Brighton already. The second one I'm working at the moment using the Arctic footage, and I'm presenting that at a festival informed by notions of ritual over in Portland, Oregon, in about 2 weeks' time.
Yeah. And so while you're in the Arctic, what did you see the effects of climate change? I mean, what did you learn about not just climate change, but about that part of the world, you know,
what was most intriguing to me was the sort of sociological aspect, in the sense that the Svalbard Treaty, which is the legally binding treaty that I think was it was conceived of and signed in the 20s, I believe, authorizes all member states, so all the sort of nations who have signed the Svalbard Treaty, to access and use and live for free on Svalbard, and they have equal rights across it, even though it's Norwegian sovereignty.
Yeah.
But they are also, in as much as they're entitled to exploit the natural resources, which is largely coal, they're also obliged to be responsible for the ecological maintenance of it. So it has this kind of sort of quasi-utopian kind of sensibility, which was absolutely fascinating to me and really, really inspiring. And yes, of course, the Arctic itself is shrinking because of everything we're doing to the climate. But the people within Svalbard, it tends to be sort of research scientists. There is a tourism arm, but even within that, there's a strong emphasis on ecological awareness, which is really, really awesome.
Yeah.
That's what I took away from that, was the sense of all these sort of, I think it's about 43 signatories. So all these different nations interacting and living within a really, really sparely populated environment.
Yeah.
And a really hostile one. You know, it's not a kind or sort of amenable environment to human habitation.
Yeah. Did you have to have any preparation before you went settled, went to, on the trip? Was there any preparatory stuff?
Well, in terms of keeping warm, absolutely. We were really thermaled up, you know.
Yeah.
It was minus 10 one day with a 45-kilometre wind, which was and sideways horizontal snow, which was absolutely blistering, you know. Also, in future, I will go back with, like I said, camera batteries and things. In that kind of temperature, they deplete really, really quickly. I got through about 30 batteries in the space of a day, so I'll be more prepared next time in terms of that respect.
But, yeah. Where can we find out more about your work? Have you got a website?
Absolutely. Well, on Twitter, it's the Academy of Sun, which is my band, but I also use that to express everything that I'm working on.
So that's the Academy
of Sun.
Of Sun.
Yeah,
okay.
That's the. I'm wearing product placement.
Yeah.
The project itself is called the Quiet Earth Global Hypersigil Project, but I'll email you that as well.
Yeah.
There's a Facebook page on that, which is where I'm posting notes and drafts and bits of footage and stuff and relevant links and things. Yeah.
Okay, great. Nick, all the best with the exhibition,
thank you so much.
And we'll catch up again soon.
Great, thank you. Have
Thanks.
A great day, all right? Thank you. Bye-bye.